Hello, this is Jashykins. Oh, well, I've been taking a trip. Yeah, it was running away from the Terminators. How did you guess? Yeah, I'm sure I can defeat the Terminator. I'm positive. You don't have to worry about it. Yeah, I did sort of give up a little bit. Yeah. You don't have to send anyone to help me. I can do it myself. Okay, fine. If you want to send someone to help defeat the Terminator for me, go ahead. See that guy later. Bye. Well, if you're wondering where I've been for the past couple weeks, I've sort of been running away. Yeah. Yeah. And, seems like the Resistance going to send someone to save me, so everything will be okie dokie. And I guess, better finish up the Terminator review while I still can. This is the final part. Enjoy.
It is your destiny.
Fuck my destiny.
Sarkisian returned my call. We'll meet about selling the Turk.
He's still got it? When's the meeting?
Tomorrow morning.
Meaning that this news could have waited?
What I'm going to say is going to anger, it's going to anger all of you who consider yourselves to be true Terminator fans. And that is that the Terminator is my least favorite of the Terminator movies. I mean, it's well done and everything, but the first time I saw it, I wasn't that impressed. And once I saw it multiple times after becoming a Terminator fan, I still wasn't impressed. Now for my rating of the Terminator. Now, just because I consider the Terminator to be the worst Terminator film does not mean I'm going to give it a low rating, because, well, it did do what it did correctly really, really, really good. So I give the Terminator a 4 out of 5. The atmosphere it creates is awesome. Arnold Schwarzenegger as the Terminator is just outstanding. And of course, the action sequences are pretty sweet. They are really good action sequences, and you need good action sequences for a Terminator film. Now, what I think it did wrong was the relationship between Kyle Reese and Sarah Connor. It's really highly cliched, and why Kyle loves Sarah is just really creepy if you go to think about it for like 2 fucking seconds. But if you're a Terminator fan, or you're someone who's just becoming a Terminator fan, you need to see The Terminator. It sets down all the ground rules and is really the cornerstone of the whole series. While it's the worst, it is the cornerstone. It's the one that is that made a sequel. That, you know, made the Terminator series become a series. So you should see it for that. And of course, if you're an Arnold Schwarzenegger fan, you have to see The Terminator, as I believe his role of The Terminator is his best role ever. It's just really the role that was made for him. And saying it again, I give The Terminator a 4 out of 5.
Well, thank you. Well, good news. The resistance fighter claims he killed the Terminator. However, I don't know, there just seems something wrong, like he was lying or, I don't know, it wasn't like he was being totally honest. But, well, at least, you know, the Terminator threat is gone, so I can continue doing whatever it is I do whenever I'm not filming. In peace. So, yes, I feel sort of good. I don't have a Terminator after me, hopefully. Well, I hope you all enjoyed my The Terminator review. I hope you thought my rating of it was fair. And, of course, I hope that you're glad I'm still alive. And that I hopefully won't get into any real mess with an actual Terminator anytime soon. Yeah. Well, until next video, goodbye. Sometimes I wanted to cry when the people on TV were not quite the way we were. Somehow I guess I just knew. But I didn't know I love you so much. I didn't know I love you so much. I didn't know. Stay up all night, wishing to God that I was the one who died. And sometimes there's not enough time. But I didn't know I loved you so much. I didn't know I loved you so much. I didn't know I loved you so much.